Warning, this video contains high-speed internet. Please watch responsibly. This is a story about a man named Jesse who travels the nation in search for a World Series gold ring. He knows it's going to be a very, very, very long trip. He's going to need to employ the best of the best of the Jew crew, including Paul, Jeff, and Neil. They first searched for the ring in Graceland. They looked in the living room. They looked in the TV room. They looked in Elvis's trophy room. And they looked everywhere in between. To no avail, they could not find the ring. They each took a car and flew out of there, heading to Mobile, Alabama, and LSU in Baton Rouge. Still not being able to find the ring, they searched every bridge and every Cracker Barrel in the South. Every beach, no ring. Sure enough, they gave it a day's rest, heading to New Orleans. They took the night off and partied in Bourbon Street, where they ate and they ate and they ate. Everything in sight did they eat until their bellies were completely full. And then they drank and they drank and they drank until they could not see straight. This, sure enough, cost them a hefty bill. After that, they lit shit on fire, listened to some music, and danced the night away. So take it off like you're home alone. You're not dancing for the mirror while you're on the phone. Checking your reflection and telling your best friend, like, girl, I think my sex is it's getting hot. So take off all your clothes. They went to the cabins where Drunken Jesse professed a deep, deep, dark secret. He was suffering from selfieitis, the addiction of producing selfies. In the morning, they went to Ceviche and placed a hefty bet on the Denver Broncos winning the AFC championships.
Let's try that video.
Quarter 1-2.
Come on, let's go, Broncos. Get him, yes!
Woo! Sure enough, they won, and they went to collect their money. Little did they know, Paul took his gun and robbed the Jew crew, killing Jeff and kidnapping Neil and Jesse. He took him to the desert and deserted him there. Jesse swore vengeance. In the middle of nowhere, they walked many terrains to find civilization. Eventually, they landed upon the Big Texan, where they spoke with a clown who told them of the real identity of Paul. The clown told us Paul's real name is Paulie the Dream Killer, and he's an international criminal who works with the Japanese mafia. He planned to use this computer to blow up one of the World Series of Poker circuit stops. Determined to stop him, Jesse and Neil decided to travel to each stop and play in their tournaments to win a ring and to find Paul. They played all the tournaments, but to no luck, no ring, and they could not find Paul anywhere. Defeated, they went to the Flying Saucer, played a game of darts, and headed to West Palm Beach, Florida, where they stayed at the Grinder's Grotto.
Alright, here's the house. Here's the living room. peeps. Stay with us.
They then met up with all the grinders and formed a plan to defeat Polly once and for all. The grinders included Sir Capsalot, Papa Neil, the Coug, Donald Duck, J-Bolt, J-Bolt's masseuse, Steven Sniper, Robbie Dangerfield, the Gooch, and Perez Hilton. White Rice, Brown Rice, and Turbo, Tinder 1 and Tinder 2, Young Heck, Christian P, the real Christian P, Cody Public Urination Pack, Thor, Thor's Hammer, The Cooler, Man, Fish Scales, One Ring Ting, The Darkness, and their mascot, CeCe the Rehabilitated No Tanking Turtle. Together they prayed. One by one they fell. The Darkness fell when his 3-deuce offsuit bluff ran into pocket fives, and Young Heck lost his pocket sixes against pocket jacks, leaving the final two, Polly the Dream Killer versus J Bolt. The grinders railed in anticipation. When all the quarters were in, J Bolt defeated Polly the Dream Killer. And as Polly went to the payout desk, he vowed never to commit a crime ever again. To celebrate, they all went to Okeechobee Steakhouse, and for Jesse's birthday, ate steaks, drank wine, and looked back on what a crazy trip it had all been. The end. I'm